What are your thoughts about Rob Manfred going on Fox Business Network and saying he is not going to strip the World Series titles from the Astros or the Red Sox? He said, I think the answer from our perspective is to be transparent about what the investigation showed and let our fans make their own decision about what happened.
Well, you know, I'm not a big guy on stripping things because we all know who won the Heisman when Reggie Bush won it. You know, we all know that Pete Carroll at USC won those games. I will say it's a little different for me, Michael, in this perspective, because it's one thing to have an ineligible player and that be a reason why things are vacated, but it's another thing to blatantly break the rules of the competition, right? To me, that's a different level. However, I still don't think that, like, stripping or vacating is going to do anything in terms of, I mean, to me, it's a useless exercise from my
perspective. Yeah, but, you know, but one thing, though, the players literally got off scot-free then.
They still get
to call themselves world champions, no monetary damage whatsoever, no damage to their reputation other than peripherally. They got off scot-free. They're still world champions.
What I do find interesting about that is, like, Jim Crane is ramping this thing up. You know, obviously, baseball didn't say that A.J. Hinch and Luno had to be fired. Jim Crane did.
True.
And then he went out there and said, after, you know, Altuve and said what he said and Bregman said nothing, which I find hilarious for the most loquacious chirper of all time, talking about the show stros and all this kind of stuff. Suddenly he says, well, the report is the report. You know, that wasn't good enough for Crane. He said they are going to make a formal apology, and they're going to apologize when they come to spring training, either individually or together as a team. So it was whatever it wasn't good enough for the guy who does sign their check.
I find it amazing, though, in situations like that, that, you know, he said yesterday in spring training they're going to apologize. He knew they were at FanFest. Wouldn't you think that they would have rallied them around, sat them down, and told them how to answer these questions? Instead, you don't give them any direction, and obviously their first direction is going to be protect their backside.
I agree. If you were going to do it, that would have been a really, really smart place to start getting it done. I have no idea how hands-on Jim Crane is on the day-to-day operations or was before all this stuff has come out. Because let's be honest, it's been a horrible 4 or 5 months for the Houston Astros organization with everything that's going on. So maybe this is Jim at this point deciding to say, I need to be more involved here and make sure that everybody understands the way I want this business to be run. But you're right, they missed an opportunity, and they swung and missed, something they never did when they knew what the pitch was coming.
Right.
But second time around, it looks like, hey, there it is. It looks like now they're going to say, that was not good enough. We need to do a better job.
But Michael's right. They get away with it, and that's why I think stripping the title is something that should be on the table. I understand that it's maybe just a gesture, but I don't see the negative in it. And the other thing, too, we shouldn't be conceited enough to think that the world revolves around our lifetime. You vacate that title, Trey, 200 years from now, there's going to be no champion, and you're going to have an explanation why there was no champion in 2017 and 2019 and 2018 if they did it to the Red Sox. And it'll never be forgotten. You know, the whole Fred Shiro, we win today, we walk together forever. Or when Bill Parcells, they can never take the championship away from you. Well, they can. And we'll all know who won. But years from now, they will know why they didn't win.
John, that's a great question, actually. Is it legitimately within his power to do that?
Well, I would think so. They do in the NCAA. You would think that he has more power.
Right, but let's be clear. The last business I want to model myself after is the NCAA.
That's true.
I would really like to know that. I don't know what the relationship is and how that's worded, if at all, between the Players Association and Major League Baseball. I would actually be really curious to know about that. I mean, we didn't have a World Series because of a commissioner. Bud Selig in '94 said, you know, we're just shutting it down. So I guess he could, but I'm really curious as to know how that might work, might or might not work out.